Hey, YouTube. We're cruising around Maine and on a back road, and I came across a guy who does a bunch of metal artwork, and asked him if I could do a little video for my YouTube, and I said, sure, go right ahead. So we're just going to go walk around his property and see the kind of stuff he makes. And I paid to get rid of my propane tanks. I feel like I'm walking around 63 in Palo's yard. And I'm peeing at that pump. Why I have such a hard time throwing anything away myself. I'd almost drive that. The band. Give him another plug. Look where the mushroom's big. Or Peaks Rat Rod. Every one of your neighbors brings the scrap metal to you, right?
What's that?
Every one of your neighbors brings the scrap metal to you?
I try to get them to, but it isn't that easy, believe it or not.
Really?
You know, people throw things on the car and in the car and head to the dump. They don't stop and think about the guy down the road who might need it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I have probably half a dozen people that
know you and hook you up.
The junkers, they know to get the money from me for it.
I'm that way with tractors. Everybody brings me their tractors.
Old farm tractors would be nice.
Yeah, they got
a lot of
nice stuff on them.
Yeah.
Your vision's pretty cool. How do you come about? Do you just look at stuff in a pile and just start going, or?
Yeah, you know, sometimes a piece of junk looks like something, and you just work with it.
Sure.
over the years I've developed quite a pile of things, but the thing is there's no, it's not financially all that bright because you can't get the price that it's really worth.
Sure.
You have to, in order to sell, you have to sell it, you know, better than Walmart price, but not what you ought to get for your time, you know.
For being that.
Well, especially if you add in the collecting the raw material, you know. And people assume since it's junk or old metal that it's, you know, not hard to come by or that you can just get it anywhere.
Sure. As a collector of stuff myself, I know you. I hear you.
Well, that's what it started. It was, you know, dump picking and.
Then you started looking at it, saying, "I have to do something with this stuff."
And yeah, but then the problem became that once you find something to do something, once you find something to do with it, that you can't find more of it. You know, especially the old iron.
Yeah.
The old.
Yeah.
I've got quite a collection, and I search it out, and whenever I can prevent it from heading into the junkyard, I'll get better than junk price for it. But trying to get the guys to come by, you know, if they're already going by, maybe, you know, but if they're not going to go out of their way to bring you junk.
Sure, sure. They're just in for the dollar, not for the what it comes out to be.
$300 a ton. It's hard to.
Yeah.
I can't really compete that easy.
I know. I'll go take a meander down here.
Yep. Take your time.
Cool. Thank you. That's pretty cool. Yeah. I might have to do this in two parts. This stuff just keeps going. Look at the ants up on top of the hill there, not up on the wall. Okay. My kind of woman. It's a hard body. That's a Dodge. Been out in the sun too much. Couple shrimp. Seahorse. We got some big shrimp in Maine. Some lobster. we're going to do two parts. I'm going to kind of stop it at here. See from Whoville? I come up on this stuff, I don't even see it until I'm right up on top of it. All right, we'll take a break here.